Okay, so just so I get an idea of who I'm talking to today, who in the room has used Foreman? Okay, handful. And those of you who didn't, who's at least aware roughly of what it does, what its role is? All right, that's good. So about 50-50. In that case, I'm going to go through an introduction on Foreman itself first, just to show you the role it fits within your data center, the sort of tasks it can perform, and how it integrates with other systems. So some background about myself. I'm a software engineer with Red Hat. I work full-time on the Foreman project, and I've been in the configuration and systems management space for quite a few years, mostly doing consultancy work. Now doing engineering, the Foreman project itself has been around for about 4 years, and I've been working on that for the last 18 months. So I'm going to skip first the agenda. So the introduction to Foreman, and then we're going to talk a bit about how Foreman works with another configuration management tool, very popular one, before going on to how it works in the Chef area in particular. I'll show you a quick demo of provisioning and how Chef fits into that, how we can view the data in Foreman about Chef. I'll show you how some of that integrates and fits together before asking you to help us in improving the Chef integration. So this is a bit of a long slide deck, so I'm going to go through it quite fast. Please shout, ask me questions if you'd like me to concentrate on a particular bit. It covers all of Foreman, so why it exists, some of the features within it, and a bit about the background. So we say Foreman fits into, sort of covers three categories of tasks. So it helps with initial installation of your hosts in your data center. So this can be bare metal machines. It can be hosts on a virtualization infrastructure like Ovirt or OpenStack Nova. It can also help in cloud environments, so we provision onto Rackspace, onto Amazon EC2, Google Compute Engine. And it leads us through into configuration, both the initial configuration of the machine and ongoing management. And we do that through tools like Puppet, like Chef. And we concentrate on managing updates, monitoring drift on these machines, being fed by reports and data coming back out of the configuration management system. So we call it provisioning, configuration, and monitoring. So as I said, we do bare metal provisioning. So your typical Pixie, Kickstart, ISOs, USBs through here. And we try and unify that with virtualization as well. We try and give a single unified interface, whether you're provisioning onto a cloud, onto virtualization, or bare metal. So we try and make it as similar as possible with a single process. We are Puppet focused. We are Puppet focused today. And this is what we're trying to change at the moment. So we've typically been a Puppet ENC, supporting parameterized classes, reports, facts, and other standard features similar to Puppet dashboard. And here we see Chef being introduced as being Foreman being a source, a store for Puppet and Chef reports and facts. Foreman's able to track trends, analyze statistics, and give you overviews with dashboards of your hosts and the data coming back from them. And so we've got a very centralized architecture. It's a Ruby on Rails application at its core. So Ruby on Rails 3.2 for Foreman server itself. And we extend out using our smart proxy agents to interface to other pieces of infrastructure in your environment. So DNS servers, TFTP servers, config management systems are all handled via the, what we call the smart proxy, which is like an agent. Traditionally, it's been a web interface. We're now working on an API v2, which is a very powerful, RESTful API to all the functions that you can access through the UI, and a corresponding command line interface called Hammer that allows you access to the API, so you can script the same actions. The Foreman server itself reaches out to compute environments, compute resources, as we call them, to manage virtual machines, to be able to create, edit, destroy VMs and hosts. So the smart proxy itself, as I said, manages DNS, DHCP, TFTP, the sort of prerequisites for provisioning, particularly with bare metal. It can help us with Puppet certificate signing, BMC, so power management, Realm integration with IPA or Active Directory. We'll talk a bit more about Chef later, I suspect. We've got a long line of compute resources that we support. The latest addition to this list via a plugin is Docker. So that's coming in form of 1.5 in the near future. And so the inventory, which I'll show you in the demo, is where we collect all of the information, all of the facts sent from Chef back to Foreman. So it provides you an interface where you can search, view graphs, view trends, all through the same web UI. Here's a picture of the dashboard. We'll be seeing a bit more of that later. It shows you the sort of overall state of your environment, number of hosts in each particular state, sort of error states and out of sync, which ones are currently reporting in and which ones are active or okay. So this is the detail of a single report. This is a Puppet report. The same interface is used for Chef, and we unify the two together. So we're able to handle multiple report types, multiple fact types. Skip through Puppet. So provisioning, we support a whole range of operating systems out of the box. So Foreman itself, we provide packages for Debian, EL, Fedora, Ubuntu, and beginning to do FreeBSD as well. But we can provision a range of operating systems from the same ones to SLES to Solaris, and even Windows. Parts of Foreman's feature set for managing and provisioning hosts is orchestration. So we're able to handle a large number of steps that enable you to provision a host. So if you think particularly when you're doing a virtual machine creation, we've got to set up the DNS entries first, the DHCP reservations, the TFTP menus, before we create the virtual machine. And all of this is handled through orchestration when you create or even destroy hosts, so we can roll back and destroy. We're building a lot on RBAC at the moment, a feature called Organizations and Locations. The latest Foreman 1.5 release, which is going into release candidate status shortly, has a brand new group-based RBAC system, which gives you fine-grained control down to individual resources in your Foreman setup. So you can assign access to view or edit or destroy individual resources to groups of users. We've got a powerful installer. This is Puppet-based, Puppet modules, but it gives you a full top-to-bottom setup. So it's very easy to get going. And among these plugins, which is where a lot of our development is happening now, we can add Chef. Be the focus of the talk today. So I'm going to skip through the remaining slides because I think that covers most of that. As I said, the community is about 4 years old. It started off with Ohad Levy, who wrote this for his own company. It's now being developed. We have 60 developers sitting on the IRC channels and on the mailing lists. We get a huge range of contributions all the way from to our documentation, through to the core code, the modules that make up our installer, and through to translations. So we're now shipping in 6 languages. The community's been growing rapidly in the last year or so. It's been pretty phenomenal. The number of users on the IRC channels and mailing lists has increased dramatically. The community around it, in terms of plugins, in terms of walkthroughs, users being able to help out is pretty big now. And we've got a big line of famous users of Foreman, CERN is our probably one of our biggest deployments. They use Foreman to manage all of their bare metal hosts and manage their public infrastructure. They scale it right out. It's been used in some very large environments. So I'm going to go back to the chef-focused bits now and talk a bit about how Foreman integrates, particularly with configuration management. So facts and reports are the main two pieces of data that get sent into Foreman when you run a configuration management tool. We can start going deeper, start integrating deeper with the configuration management tool. In the case of Puppet, we're able to learn which modules and which classes are available to us. So we're able to scan those. We're able to manage some of the parameters, some of the data associated with those classes, and then determine to Puppet via the ENC interfaces what each host should look like. Now, for Chef, we're up to stage two of this. So we've got facts and reporting. We're trying to get down to do the run list determination with some of the new features, such as config groups. I'll talk about that a bit later. So traditionally in Puppet, we begin by sending facts up to the server, and these get uploaded straight into Foreman before we can determine how to treat the host that's checked in. Foreman's going to determine which classes are applicable to this using groupings, using association of classes to hosts. And we can say, well, this host, nodex.example.com, needs these classes with this data. And that gets sent back through the Puppet Master down to the agent. And of course, at the end, you get a report back. Very simple. And it's the same with Chef. You know, we have the node checking in, asking for its run list. And both the facts and reports get uploaded at the end of the run in this case. So we've implemented the Chef Foreman handler, and this is hooking into the Chef agent to upload the facts, upload the report, and give us fine-grained resource-level reporting back to Foreman. And we interpret this the same way as we would in Puppet, so giving you a unified interface, whether using one, the other, or both. The layout of the Chef setup, it can be done in one of two ways. You can have your agents uploading directly to the Foreman server, or you can have them proxying via the smart proxy agent that I mentioned earlier. So you can have something that's local to your subnets, that's local to your physical machines, handling requests, authenticating the requests, and then forwarding these on to Foreman. So we can see here at the top, we have three nodes. These are sending their reports through the Chef handler up to the Foreman proxy. And this is going to authenticate with the Chef server on the left-hand side, chef.example.com. And then finally upload the data that it's received back from the hosts to Foreman itself. So we can see a diagram of the events here. So we've assumed the Chef clients run already, and we're receiving a fact upload sent by Chef client. So it's going to hit the Foreman smart proxy first, and then the proxy is going to call out back to the Chef server to find out the public key of the client. And that's our authentication step. We're handling untrusted data, potentially untrusted data from a node. We're able to authenticate that it's a known node. It's known to the Chef server before we begin to forward facts back up to Foreman. The demo I'm going to show you today, I'm going to skip the authentication stuff. We're going to be uploading directly from the clients straight up to the Foreman server. It's a very simple setup. So I want to give you an end-to-end demo of provisioning. So being able to show you Foreman's orchestration capabilities. So you'll see a VM be provisioned, in this case, on KVM, on LiveVirt on my laptop. We'll provision the Chef agent onto the new host, bootstrap it, sign it up to the Chef server, and then receive its facts and reports on an ongoing basis. So before I start with that, are there any questions or things he would like me to expand upon. Okay. So, fingers crossed. So this is the dashboard we mentioned earlier. This is a preview of Foreman 1.5. This is what will be the RC1 next week. And we can see here a pie chart showing us the three states of the three VMs I have running on my laptop. So we have hosts in a good state. We've received reports recently from them. At the moment, Foreman's configured to expect them every 30 to 35 minutes. We can see an out-of-sync host down here, single one. And this means we haven't received a report within that time period. It's out-of-sync, it could be off, might be on, the agent may not be running. And host with no reports. So this is a host that has no configuration management tool. Is this visible at the back? I know the screens are a little small. If I zoom out. Yep, okay. The other information we've got displayed on here are some of the events, some of the reports that are coming in on the left, bottom left-hand side. We'll go into this in some more detail. And a very large run distribution graph, because I've set my agents to run once a minute through cron. The second major screen in Foreman is the host list. And we can see here a bit more detail, including the operating systems, the hypervisors they're based on, so localhost and box, so the model, hardware model, and the host groups, which are our kind of templates for what these hosts should look like, how they should be configured. We can see here at the top, cClient 6, it's got no changes. So the last report that we received from Chef on here didn't contain any modifications. And we can click through and view a bit more detail about tests. So this is handler information is being collected by the Chef Foreman handler and then being pushed up to Foreman through the API, giving us a list of the resources that have been asserted and some timing information as well about, in this case, the service took 75% of the runtime. We can also filter by log level up here. So just looking for the interesting items, errors, things that have changed. So if there were errors in this report, we'd see it both on the host screen, the dashboard, and in report information, the detailed reports. Foreman's also able to do email notifications when you have bad reports coming in. We're able to do nightly sort of cron jobs, giving you summaries of the day's activity as well. So the status information in the reports is very important. It can be used for a number of things, including your own custom hooks and scripts. So I'll show you first a bit about how we configure the agent. So we have provisioning templates, and these run in a variety of ways. We have templates for a number of operating systems, as I've said. So we have pre-seeds, we have kickstarts, auto-yast, and jumpstarts for Solaris, and FreeBSD now, actually. And we have a snippet, which is responsible just for the Chef configuration. Now, this may be hard to read. Let me try. Okay. So this is very simple. We're just installing the Chef client. I've actually got a cached copy here, which is what you're seeing, or you could pull it from Opscode. We install a gem that contains the handler and then do a bit of configuration in the client.rb to set it up, just telling it what type of facts and reports to upload. There are additional settings as well if you want to remove the debug outputs or just send up warnings or errors. You have to forgive me, this is a bit basic. And then just doing a bit of bootstrapping just for the initial run list. It's pretty similar to how we handle Puppet here, and these templates can be entirely customized. Different people have different ways of bootstrapping this. For Puppet in particular, we do certificate signing on the server, and that can be orchestrated. And you can extend that system, or you can add your own you can change the templates that you use for kickstarting and pre-seeding. And this snippet I wrote, you'll find it at the end of the presentation. I'll give you the URL if you want it. So this is going to be run either by a kickstart, so J. So for example, here a default kickstart. Now it can either configure Puppet there, or it can configure Chef here, based on the parameters assigned to that single host that we create. I'm going to be doing image-based provisioning on KVM. So in this case, Foreman will SSH into the newly created host, and it will run a finish script. It will upload this script over SSH, chmod it, and execute it. So this is much the same as you do at the end of a kickstart, just installing perhaps some additional packages, some additional configuration. So you're installing just enough operating system to get going before handing off to the config management tool. And down here, we call the snippet. So that's managed separately. So if I go through to the new host creation, we're given a form with a lot of fields. And most of this we're going to pre-populate using host groups. So I have a host group that's set up specifically for my libvirt environment, and then a subgroup beneath that, nested inside, for the Chef configuration. Now this has some extra data assigned to it, just to help with the bootstrapping. We're saying we want Chef. We're giving it an initial run list, and the bootstrap role on here is just going to set up the Chef client onto a cron job, pointing at the Chef URL, and that would be my private key. So the options you have when creating a new host are largely operating system based, largely about the provisioning process that you're going to use. So here I'm able to select one of a number of compute resources, so cloud providers or virtualization systems, hypervisors, that I can deploy my new host onto. So I'm going to choose libvirt here, which is connecting back through a TCP, in this case, to localhost. And I have a compute profile that's going to set up a lot of the attributes associated with a virtual machine, things like which libvirt network to put it on, how much storage I'd like associated with it. So you could have, say, small, medium, large profiles. The network information helps us with DNS and DHCP orchestration. So I'm able to select the domain that DNS records will be created in, the realm, so Active Directory or IPA realms. And in this case, the IP address has been assigned via DHCP, or pre-reserved. The operating systems I've got pre-configured, and for the case of libvirt, I can pixie boot, which I'm not going to attempt over conference Wi-Fi, or image-based, something I've pre-prepared earlier. Yeah, coward. So as we've seen here, we set up this finished script already. I've already shown it to you. We can verify it's the right one. The virtual machine information, this is where we begin to get specific about the compute resource we're deploying onto. And this I've set up for libvirt using the pre-prepared profile. Showing you the parameters. So let's go. Didn't fill in the name, did I? Okay. So we'll see a number of steps happening here. So this is the orchestration that I talked about earlier. So actually first creating the VM to get its MAC address before being able to put in DHCP reservations, both forward and reverse DNS records. Once we've got that, we'll power up the VM, ready for it to pixie boot or to boot into the image in this case. And now we're just waiting for it to start up. So. That's the wrong one, pre-prepared earlier. So we're just booting up the image. This is actually a Vagrant libvirt image with a username password that Foreman's aware of to carry out the bootstrapping. So once this is booted up and SSHD has begun, Foreman will SSH in, run the finish script, and bootstrap. Any moment now. The script, as we saw, will just download the Chef client, drop on the validator PEM, and then kick off the first Chef client run. Looks like it's still booting. Still not up. Okay. Oops. Okay, so that's booted up now. It's actually using Cloud Init, this image, to put some of the initial users on. It's just a stock CentOS 6.4 image with some extra user data injected. And there we go. So the SSH script has executed. It's bootstrapped it. And if we go back to the host list now, we see that the ChefConf 2014 host is active. And this means that the last report we received had some changes. We actually made some modifications on the host. And we'll see via the report that we've just set up Chef Client as a cron job. So that's now going to run every minute. And we'll get continuous reports back from it. And it's visible on our dashboard in active state. So, behind the scenes, the integration between the Chef client and Foreman is pretty simple. We've sort of worked back from what we did with Puppet originally. The Puppet stuff has been very a very long time, that's how it started off. But you know, they follow many of the same concepts. So we threw away a lot of the Puppet specific stuff and created new APIs for uploading facts generically and uploading reports. So we're now able to upload a piece of JSON just describing key value style in a hash, facts and their values. So the Chef handler will take all the facts from the Chef client, reformat them, and upload it over REST. Reports happen in a similar way. This is still a bit puppety. We haven't quite figured out how to describe reports very generically. And so many of the fields in this report we're making to fit the data available to us. We're working at the moment to make reports truly generic and actually have separate implementations for Chef, for Puppet, and other systems like ABRT. And there are a number of places we really want to extend the Chef integration and the configuration management integration in Foreman. So first off is proper provisioning support. Not just the template I threw together hastily this morning, but actually have our stock kickstart and pre-seed templates ready to go with Chef clients bootstrapping. We want to be able to associate Chef servers, or use Chef Solo, properly with hosts. So at the moment we would manage, say, a Puppet Master using the smart proxy, and we'd identify it that way too. So you'd be creating a host and you'd say, I'd like to use this master over here, this ID. In this location. We should be able to do the same for Chef and actually give you a strong association between your Chef servers and your Chef clients, which then allows you to do RBAC, and it allows you to associate servers with locations or with organizations as well. I mentioned config groups earlier, and these are a new feature coming in Foreman 1.5. And they're designed as a stepping stone between a host group that a host can only have one of. And we think they're probably analogous to roles in Chef, but without, at the moment, ordering. So these would typically describe a number of other modules or pieces of configuration recipes that would be assigned either via a host group or directly to a host. So they allow you to have, say, base config groups with config groups per hardware type or per operating system and combine these together. And so I think these can probably be linked through to chef roles. Something I've also been trying to do is configure the handler at runtime using chef handler recipe cookbook. There's a technical issue with that, but I'm stuck on the chef client class. So if anybody's familiar with the internals of handlers, I'd really appreciate a hand after. And the other is a bit more open. As I've said, we can integrate with configuration management at a number of levels. And for us, it's trying to find out where the best place is to stop, where we provide the best value to users, and where we don't overlap too much with existing tools, say, Chef Enterprise or the Chef Server UI. The Overt project is a virtualization project, and we have support for it in Foreman. And we've done some work with them to integrate bits of their UI into ours and bits of our UI into theirs. So you're able, say, to browse your host on your virtualization infrastructure while seeing the configuration management reports and status from Foreman. Or you're able to see, say, the virtualization state within the Foreman UI. So this may be a way to bring some of the data from, say, the Chef server through into our UI, or expose some of our capabilities, some of our provisioning, or host management into the Chef side. So there are lots of places where you can get involved. The templates is a really good place to begin. We have a repository called Community Templates that stores all of our kickstarts, pre-seeds, and snippets. And we'd love to get some contributions to that to help us do Chef properly and help new users get into Chef and get into Foreman and Chef. So with that, a few pointers as to where to begin. Our website is at theforeman.org, so theforeman rather than Foreman. And we have two projects that bring the Chef capabilities in. The first is a plugin to Foreman called Foreman Chef, and the second is the handler, which is distributed as a gem, Chef Handler Foreman. The little crummy snippet I showed you earlier is up on Gist on GitHub. And then after this session at 3:15, there's an office hours session. So do come along if you'd like to sit down and go through this or give it a try. I'd be happy to guide you through. So with that, thank you very much. I'm open to any questions now. If there are. Yep. Yes, it's VOHI data coming back. I'm not sure if the attributes entirely are sent through. I am, because I know Puppet. Actually, yes, it is containing the attributes as well. Yeah. Okay, for example, that's a cookbook that I've associated to the host. At the back, yeah. I think we're a lot closer with, sorry, so the question for those who didn't hear it is how close are we to parity between Chef and Puppet and Foreman? We're far at the moment. We have the plugins available. We have it packaged. The community has traditionally been a Puppet community, and both developers and users, the majority of users are that way. A lot of the work we've done, we've been careful to package and make very available to people. We've tried to make sure our stable releases, such as Foreman 1.4, work well with Chef plugins, and that Chef plugins can easily be installed and used. We haven't, the big steps are making it easily installable, and then probably something around the run list integration in the UI to make it easy to manage how your host will actually be run. It's probably the installer that helps Puppet users the most, in that it is both setting up Foreman and Puppet in a default configuration. And if we could extend that to Chef, I think we'd bring a lot of parity to the situation. Anybody else? Okay, thank you very much.